Hey everybody, so yesterday I cut my finger really bad on my blender. Well, the blade to my blender, I was washing it, and I messed up my finger. So I can't tattoo this week. The doctor said I have to take the whole week off because I can't bend it, and I cannot straighten it out too much, or the cut will open up and I'll bleed to death. So today I'm gonna tell you how to get your sleeve tattooed in three easy steps. So this is a conversation I have really often with clients to where they have a bunch of random tattoos that they got that they didn't really think through, or they didn't really have an idea of what they wanted their sleeve to look like, and now they want a full cohesive sleeve to where it looks like it's all put together in one piece. So I end up, you know, puzzling their sleeve together, which is fun because it's kind of challenging to try to see what fits in what spot. It's also challenging kind of in a bad way because then we're kind of limited on, you know, say the client has a really cool idea and the space they have won't allow for that. So I just wanna help you, and even if you're a tattoo artist, kind of think things through and try to, you know, make you think about how to plan out your sleeve and what will work for you. So step number one is to research and find an artist that does large scale work in the style that you like. If you just wanna go get a sleeve on a walk-in, you're gonna be pretty disappointed because that's just not how that works. Walk-in artists usually just do single session work, and sleeves take multiple sessions and a lot of planning. You know, it's not just like a quick sketch that you can throw together. So after you found your artist and you set up a consultation with him, tip number two is to bring a lot of reference pictures to the consultation. You want to show him what style you like, and also it's important to bring certain things that you don't like about that style, or, you know, say you want a Buddha themed sleeve, but you don't like certain elements of these other Buddha themed sleeves that you've seen. So that's important for him to know, so then that way he just doesn't draw that up thinking like, oh, this person's gonna love this, and then when you get there, you hate it. So show him what you like, show him what you don't like, and then that way he knows what to do. Because we're not mind readers, people. Moving on to tip number three, you have to commit. If you're working on a sleeve or a large scale tattoo, you don't want to come back every 2 years to work on it. You want to come back every couple weeks to every couple months. This way, not only will you finish your sleeve faster and you'll look cooler sooner, but all of the ink will settle into your skin evenly and your sleeve will look consistently vibrant. If you get work done on it every year or two, then you're gonna be able to tell which tattoos are older and which tattoos are the newest. If you're ready to commit to a large scale tattoo, I recommend booking multiple sessions at once. So then that way you have all of your dates set and you don't have to worry about, especially if the artist is really busy. Say you come in for your consultation and you book out, you know, however many sittings he thinks it'll take to finish your tattoo. Say it's six sittings to finish a sleeve. So then that way you come in for your consultation, you book your initial appointment that you're coming in for the first one, and then you book the other five, you know, however you guys want to space it out. So then that way all of your dates are set. You don't have to worry about it, and you're not waiting forever to get back in with that artist, and everything will already be set for you. That's how I think you should go about doing a sleeve or any type of large scale work in general. So yeah, those are my tips. I'm gonna go nurse my finger back to health and probably make a couple more YouTube videos this week because I'm antsy and I'm bored and I want to work, but I can't. Have a good day.